Good morning. Today's video is going to be on capacity, capacidad. All of the poses that we do, no matter if we hold them for 5 minutes or 3 seconds, don't worry about trying to keep up or not keeping up. Yeah. Just notice your capacity to feel the poses that you end up being in. So, let's begin. You can sit in an easy position. This is hero. And I want you to go ahead and just close your eyes, meeting yourself right where you're at. What is your spiritual capacity today? Breathe in and breathe out. Try to keep your eyes closed. You're just meeting yourself right where you're at. Take a moment to reflect on what is your spiritual capacity today in this world. What is your physical capacity? Do you have any physical ailments? Inhaling through the nose and exhaling through the nose. And if you started off with me in hero position and felt the need to switch, don't worry about it. Switch. And your intuition, the capacity to really pay attention to your spirit's needs, your purpose, your essential purpose in life. And if you don't know your purpose at the moment, don't worry about it. You're kind of on the journey of figuring it out, so be kind with yourself. Leads us into nurturing ourselves. You're here, you've made it this far. Now, how are you nurturing yourself? How are you connecting with nature? The key is really the breath, welcoming nature into your essence, into your spirit, into your being. And meeting your emotion right where you're at. Are you a bit your mopey, depressed, sad, down energy? Are you Winnie the Pooh? Winnie the Pooh can be go with the flow, but Winnie the Pooh can also be a bit of a pushover. Constantly looking for external stimulation. Are you Tigger, but anxious energy, all over the place, not feeling grounded? Or are you Rabbit, needing everything to be in its place without judgment? Because all of these temperaments, you know, the idea is that we want to find balance with all of them, and they each have a really great qualities and then qualities that help us learn in life. So we're just meeting ourselves where we are at. Spiritually, physically, intuitively, naturally, and with emotion. Okay, so you can shift your legs. I'm gonna sit with my legs crossed. You sit wherever, however works for you. And then you're just gonna go ahead and loosen up your shoulders. Think about just rolling life off of the shoulders. A lot of times people are like, oh, my shoulders. And then I wonder, are you trying to carry the world on your shoulders when the world can carry you? So breathing in and breathing out. In through the nose and out through the nose. Just letting things roll off of your shoulders, especially the things at the moment that you just can't feel like you couldn't control. Maybe you just don't need to control it. Maybe you just need to think about letting it roll off of your shoulders. And then start to loosen up your neck. If you're hearing a lot of crunchies, maybe think about lengthening a little bit more by rooting down. What are the capacity of your movements here for your neck, your bridge between your mind body? Where is your tightness? Is it in the front, back, sides? How are you breathing here? Reversing the direction. Notice how far your head goes in each direction and where there's resistance. Stretching it out here, feeling a good stretch front, right, left quadrant of your neck. If you have migraines, if you clench your jaw, you're gonna need this instead of like folding forward. Yep. So press your hands into your chest and slide them energetically down where they're not really moving, you're applying pressure. And then you're just getting that sweet stretch here, neck muscles. Breathe in and out, go ahead and release, go ahead and take it to the other side. Spend a little bit of time here. Of course, observing where your mind goes. And breathing. Inhaling and exhaling. The muscles in the front of the neck, when they are tight, they take the skull and they compress it on your actual spine. And then it begins to apply pressure on your nervous system. Now go ahead and bring your hands to your sternum, your heart center, or your breastplate. Lift the chin up, pushing down through the elbows. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Little movements here. Keep pushing the chin up, stretching, breathing. And then loosen up the jaw. Inhaling through your nose and exhaling through your nose. How much more can your jaws tense up? Do you ever wonder? How much more? What can you allow them to soften? Good. Breathe in and breathe out. We're going to come to our tabletop for a moment, and then we're going to push up into our downward facing dog. Go ahead and just pedal your feet.
You're going to look for a place where your body feels balanced. You're stretching your lower legs, the calves and the hamstrings. And they might say, you know what, I don't have the capacity to stretch any further than this, but you might be feeling it in your shoulders. And if you're feeling it in your shoulders, simply bend your knees and then push your booty back. Then roll your shoulders back. I'm just gonna meet myself right where I'm at. I'm gonna move my head around here. Just kind of feeling the stretch in my spine, decompressing the vertebrae, noticing how am I balanced in my hands. And then I'm gonna come to tabletop again. Breathe in, breathe out. And let's press back into a child's pose. And if you find, hey, you need to put a block underneath your forehead, put a block under your forehead. How full is your gut? How'd you eat last night? How'd you eat earlier? How'd you choose to nourish yourself? Without judgment. Again, erase the judgment. Just put it aside. Yeah, you can acknowledge it. Be like, okay, I'm judging myself. And then you can be like, okay, so now I've got to deal with what all I feel. What do you feel here on your gut? Can you find the place to breathe into your lungs? What's the capacity to bring in that air into the chest cavity? Take another good breath in. Fill up the back body, back lungs. And then let's go ahead and roll right back up. Shoulders up, back and down. Breathing in, breathing out. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Now, when I think of capacity, I really do think about like, what's the capacity of my lungs? So we have five compartments in the lungs. Let's take a moment to kind of separate those compartments. Because if we can't use our lungs for what we're made and we just kind of swallow everything into our gut and we bypass these beautiful lungs of ours, yeah, then technically we're still suffocating ourselves. So mirroring you have three compartments on your right side and you have two on your left, heart. I want us to go ahead and just take a moment to just separate. So we're gonna go ahead and begin breathing into that upper right and just notice your capacity to bring in that air, yeah? To fill up, and this is called clavicular breathing. So your collarbone is essentially gonna rise up. So you're gonna breathe in just your right side and then exhale. Let's do this two more times. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now I'm gonna go ahead and do two more for my upper and I'm gonna inflate that area as much as I can. And then I'm gonna deflate it. Breathe in
Breathe out.
Good. So just observe how this area feels a little bit more open. Remember, you have three compartments on your right. I'm actually going to turn this way now. Yeah, so I can get into my right lobe. So your right lobe, find where your nipple's at, and then essentially right in that area. And I want you to think that expanding outward. We're going to do three like quicker breaths and then two slower, longer breaths. So inflate, deflate, inflate, deflate. Inflate. Deflate. Slower, longer. Inflate. Deflate. Inflate. Deflate. Let's just do one more. Breathe in. I don't even know if that was the second one, but that's okay. Inhale. Slow, long inhale. Really allow your thoracic cavity to inflate, inflate, inflate. This is the middle lobe. And then slow exhale. And then just observe, what are you feeling in that mid compartment? I'm gonna turn again. What are you feeling in the upper right, that mid right compartment? Now we're gonna go to the lower right. So diaphragmatic breathing, you wanna keep the point between your belly button and your pubic bone in towards your spine. But you're inflating, it's horizontal and it's pushing forward, and you're gonna feel it in your back. We're gonna do three shorter ones and two longer ones. Checking out like, hey, what's the capacity of these short inhales and then these long inhales or short exhales, releasing it all, long exhales. Let's begin. Inhaling lower right underneath the breast. Exhaling. Inhaling, exhaling, inhaling, exhaling, longer, slower, inhale, inflate. Exhale, deflate. Inflate. Now you can do one long breath or you can do little pumps. Inhale, 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 inhale. house count again, but that's okay. So you're going to inhale again. Lower, 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 lower. Inhaling, 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 inhaling. Exhale. Good. And just kind of observe when we cleanse our bodies, really getting into the lungs, carrying that oxygen, and then expelling the carbon dioxide properly, mindfully, you get a little high. So just notice the difference between the right lobes and the left. The muscles in between the ribs should be easier to kind of fill up and empty. We're doing capacity. Today it's really lung capacity. We're gonna bring our hands underneath. We've got three shorter breaths, yeah, and then two longer breaths. Left side, because you've got your heart, yeah, you've got two lobes on your left side. So inhale here, upper right, call it clavicular breathing. So your collarbone rises up, and exhaling, not only does it rise up, it moves outward. Inhale. Exhale, a little bit more forceful, breathing in, breathe out, long, slow inhale. Exhaling slowly. Inhaling. Exhaling. And if you have to take a few more breaths there, do that. It's totally fine. Now your lower left lobe. And if at any point you have to shift your legs, shift them. We should be able to sit in certain poses like comfortably for times and times and times without attaching. If you're getting numbness, then there is compression. And so we'll look at that in another video. But for the most part, what you would need to do, of course, is your body will naturally get out of wherever you're at. You'll kind of shake it out. And then that way your nervous system can breathe, yeah? Because when we get numbness, things are getting compressed and pinched. So adjust as you need, no judgment. Again, I'm gonna say that all throughout here right now, yeah? Because you're just looking at the capacity here and acknowledging what else you feel, liberate that, and then we'll dissect that later on. But for the most part, it's just a pinching, a loosen it. Let's move on. So the lower one, yeah, lower, three short breaths, two long breaths. Inhaling. Figure out what's the capacity of this lower left lobe, and exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Breathe in. And then breathe out. Long, slow, inhale. Exhale.
Inhale. Exhale. Good. And then just observe what you feel. And the left lungs, the right lungs, breathing in through the nose, out through the nose. And we always breathe through the nose because when we're using our mouth to breathe, then at nighttime you train your mouth to stay open. It's extremely dehydrating. So breathing in. All of the lungs, breathing out. Inhale. Exhale. Fill up your lungs, breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Let's go ahead and come back to your downward facing dog. Don't look for any discomfort if you were in here that time with me. And just pedal, pedal, pedal. You're getting blood flowing through those legs. Yep. Inhale and exhale. Remember, if you feel too much in your shoulders, it's easy. All you gotta do is just bend those knees. Bend them. That's it. Bend the knees and push your body back. Downward dog. Inhaling and exhaling. Pedal, pedal, pedal. Fill up the lungs here. That's your capacity to fill up your lungs in an upside down pose. If you've got high blood pressure, yeah, you're gonna need to bring your head above your heart if it's not maintained. Yeah, super important. Same thing if you have glaucoma, bring your head above your heart. You can also do this with your hands on the table instead. Just feeling the blood flowing through those legs. Could you hold this pose for 5 minutes? Finding that balance between your hands and your feet. We're not going to do that right now, but something to think about. Take another good breath in. Tabletop. Child's pose. Rest your forehead on a block as an option. Fill up the back lungs, inhale. Exhale. Push those back lungs into that rib cage, inhale. Feel that rib cage expand. Exhale. Breathe in. Breathe out. Let's go ahead and roll on up. Shoulders up, back and down. Come on up to your knees and your shins just for a moment. Bring your hands. If you get lightheaded, just all you gotta do is just roll up slower, find one focal point, and then just kind of stay there and then acclimate with your breathing to the new position. And you're gonna push those hips forward and Open up your chest. Just open the chest up. And you don't want to go far. If you feel like, you know, you're not able to breathe comfortably, then you've just basically gone too far. So don't go that far. Yeah, just go where it's nice for you to breathe and it's at ease with yourself. Lifting the chin up, pushing your hips forward. We haven't really done any back bends or anything. We've just really focused on what's our lungs' capacity to bring in that oxygen, to bring in the life. Breathe here. Press down with those toenails. If you have to open your eyes, open your eyes. And then let's go ahead and then we're gonna release. Sit with your legs crossed one more time. Let's close this up. Yeah. So practice breathing. The way this works, your diaphragm, diaphragmatic breathing, yeah, your diaphragm, your breathing muscle, it's activated through a nerve called the phrenic nerve in your neck, P-H-R-E-N. I see. See 3, 4, and 5 between those vertebrae. And that tells your diaphragm, hey, what's up? When we have anxiety, we completely bypass the lungs and it's like we swallow life and we put it in our gut. And people say, breathe into the belly. Don't breathe into your belly. Breathe using your diaphragm. And then from here, what I want you to think about is that diaphragm is connected to your heart sac. So, heart is over here, mine's over here, because I'm mirroring you. Yeah, so if we look at your diaphragm, heart sac, your heart sac protects your heart. So when you inhale, that heart sac is gonna pull down, kind of like a slingshot. And then when you exhale, your heart's gonna go up. Inhaling, your diaphragm contracts and flattens, and on your exhale, it relaxes. So you're actually massaging your heart. When we're depressed or we're stuck in life, the muscles in between your ribs, they freeze up. They freeze up. And so in between these ribs, we want these muscles, yeah, the fibers of these muscles to be able to be like flexing or contracting and stretching. Yeah, so deep breath, slow breath, intentional breathing. Intentional breathing, because just like sleep, we can sleep for 8 hours and not feel rested. We can say, yeah, I can breathe and feel congested, confused, foggy, just all over the place. So I want you to go ahead and just ground down through your sit bones, draw your energy up through your spine, allow decompression of that spine so that the phrenic nerve to your diaphragm can activate that diaphragm. And let's just do 5 more breaths. Put a smile on your face because that helps you to release some happiness endorphins. So breathing in, breathing out, fill up the entire lungs, activate that phrenic nerve, lengthen, breathe in, breathe out. Inhale, exhale, mouth is closed, breathe in, breathe out. Gotta do one more, breathe in. And exhale. Bring your hands to your heart. Take a nice breath in. Press the hands on that heart or that center. Thank yourself for providing breath, cleansing breath into your body, your mind, body, your spirit, your essence, your orinda. Tell yourself thanks for showing up for you. Bow down to your inner light. You can bring your arms out right in front of you. Allowing yourself to turn inward. And then roll it up. Shoulders up. Back and down. I hope you have a peaceful day. Don't forget to breathe. Y se ir respira. Y que lo pasan bien. That you have a great day. Bye.